Evening folks, this is BestInSlot, and tonight we're going to speculate a little bit about, well, this right here. Breeding Countermeasures. A piece of research you can unlock in Return to Jurassic Park, the new DLC arriving on the 10th of December. Now, this is going to be mainly speculation, but it is based in part on my personal experience getting hands-on with the DLC. As you can see from the image, this research won't be unlocked until Mission 2 on Isla Nublar, and since I only played Mission 1 and Mission 6 at the Frontier event, I did not get to experience breeding countermeasures for myself, although I do in real life. What I can say is that the research did not play a part in Mission 6, and perhaps most importantly, the research was literally not available at all in sandbox mode for either the Jurassic Park or the Jurassic World era. Not that it wasn't usable, but that breeding countermeasures was not an option on the research screen, full stop. So, what does that tell us? Well, first of all, it tells us that, generally speaking, breeding is not coming to Jurassic World Evolution. Now, we knew that already. In my opinion, the evidence for it was always super weak at best, and Stegs already confirmed on Reddit that it wasn't on the way. I'd also like to point out whilst we're here that Frontier not commenting on something is not evidence. Community managers have lives outside of browsing Reddit, and most of the speculation happened over the weekend when they weren't going to be working anyway. It also tells us that whatever breeding mechanic this is, it's limited at most to missions 2 through 5 of the Return to Jurassic Park campaign, and could possibly just be limited to mission 2 itself. For now, we'll assume that the latter is true, and speculate on how that could play out both now and in future games in the franchise. Now, canonically, the dinosaurs on Isla Nublar breeding makes actually quite a lot of sense. Though Frontier has said that all the dinosaurs in Jurassic World are female and therefore can't breed, that was also true in the original Jurassic Park, and those dinosaurs managed to breed just fine. Asexually, because of the presence of frog DNA, of course, which filled in their genetic code. Of course, raptors were breeding in Jurassic Park in both the film and the novel, and even in the more modern canon we have, it's already been established that the wild dinosaur population was breeding on Isla Nublar prior to the takeover by Masrani and the establishment of Jurassic World. So let's assume that the dinosaurs you first see in the DLC, the Brachiosauruses, the Parasaurolophuses, the Dilophosauruses and the raptors, etc., are breeding in the wild. By the end of Mission 1, these dinosaurs aren't contained other than the raptors in the raptor pen, which by the way doesn't do anything, it's a decoration, basically. The fences are fixed around the visitor center, but the dinosaurs are still doing whatever the hell they want. We saw that in the gameplay footage from the event. Wrangling control of these dinosaurs is likely the primary focus of Mission 2. All the facilities are back online, you got to take back control of the dinosaurs, and taking back control means stopping them breeding. Clearly. The question first then is, do they actually breed? Are these dinosaurs resupplying their population somehow, or is the breeding in question merely a line of text without any noticeable impact? I didn't get to experience Mission 2, but my hope is that if you sat for long enough, so long that your Brachiosaurus died of old age for example, then another one would spawn off somewhere else in the park. It'd be breeding, but a super simplified version, and one that means your dinosaur population isn't necessarily within your control. You'd then research breeding countermeasures, head out in your ranger vehicle, and you try to stop it from happening again. Alternatively, new dinosaurs simply spawn after a certain amount of time, and again, you need to prevent it. The breeding countermeasures says you need to do it to keep populations under control. It'd be a bit weird if your population was under control already without it, wouldn't it? If you could just sit there and all these dinosaurs would die of old age naturally and the population would just end, then it makes breeding countermeasures just inherently useless. This is made a little bit more interesting by a further piece of research limited to Mission 3 of the game over on Isla Sorna, the DNA sequencer. It says it uses fluorescence-based sequencing to fill gaps in dinosaur genomes and identifies undesirable traits. Now what that means, I assume, is that rather than filling gaps with frog DNA and ending up with asexually breeding dinosaurs as in Jurassic Park, you can instead use the fluorescence sequencing to build dinosaurs that never have the potential for breeding in the first place. Just this little unscripted aside, this would mean Return to Jurassic Park has to essentially take place in its own canon, because if it didn't, A, none of it would make sense anyway, but B, it would mean the breeding dinosaurs prior to Jurassic World would no longer exist, and we know they are in the modern film canon. This all makes quite logical sense for Isla Sorna, because from what we can tell, all the dinosaurs will be bred on Isla Sorna before being transported over to Isla Nublar. That was a thing in the original novels and films. i.e. the dinosaurs on Nublar need their breeding containing, and the ones on Sorna need building so that they can never breed in the first place. If you observed, well, you won't have seen it, but on mission 6 of the campaign, you didn't have a hatchery, you never birthed these dinosaurs on Isla Nublar. They were all flown over from Isla Sorna. So rather than breeding them on Nublar, you're basically flying in these modified versions that can't breed, so it stops being a problem probably after mission 3 if I had to guess. Now for me, the most interesting part of this whole thing is not necessarily how that breeding mechanic will work, or even if it's in the game. I'm still hesitant, I really don't know which way they're going to go on that. I hope we get a basic version at the very least, but it's interesting that Frontier is discussing breeding at all. They didn't have to make it a focus of this DLC, you know, it takes up two missions, seemingly. And I don't think anybody would have complained if controlling the breeding of these dinosaurs was exempt from this DLC. But they chose to. They chose to raise the topic. They chose to make it a plot point. Now, I do not think we're ever going to get a full breeding system in Evolution. It's simply far too much groundbreaking work for a post-release DLC. But down the line, could we possibly get a simplified version? No eggs or babies or ontogeny systems, of course, but simply the addition of male and female gendering to the game. Just make it random at birth, that's really easy. And then if you happen to have both of the same species with different genders, the chance of a new dinosaur randomly spawning. Maybe it'd appear magically in the wild, maybe we could have a new hatchery building which stores these new dinosaurs and then you can deliver them into your park. The major benefit of this, of course, at least the former option, is the possibility of a true-to-life Site B mode. Sandbox is already super close to letting us do it, and I don't think any such Site B mode would need to be a separate game mode, but simply a sandbox mode that doesn't require incubators or buildings of any type, or at least working ones. Isla Sorna, i.e. Site B, does have plenty of decrepit buildings on it, we just need ones that don't work necessarily, and a sandbox like that would be more reflective of Site B in The Lost World Jurassic Park. All we need is a dinosaur population that can sustain itself, and the ability for herbivores to feed from the environment and not just feeders. We're really not that far away at all. Now, if I'm being totally honest, I think any such systems are likely withheld until the expected sequel for Evolution in 2021. And I know I keep talking about that as though it's a fact, but I would be super surprised if it doesn't happen. There's a lot of evidence. Evolution sold like wildfire. Evolution 2 just makes sense. Now maybe in said sequel we can get legitimate babies, like, that's a strange sentence, like we have with Frontier's latest game, Planet Zoo. It has a full-on birth and growth system, to an extent. And if not, I'd be surprised if there wasn't some nod given to breeding dinosaurs, if not a full baby dinosaur system, something. You know, it must be now the most requested feature along with the Mosasaurus in Jurassic Park, especially with the huge number of fan features we've been given via the Return to Jurassic Park DLC. Now this is actually doubly true, not only because Frontier have opened that door themselves a tiny little bit, but that we know Jurassic World 3 is going to focus much more on wild and uncontained dinosaurs, and hell, we actually already saw a baby dinosaur in battle at Big Rock. These dinosaurs are out there now, they're breeding willfully, you know, it's not a case of their genetics or their frog DNA or anything like that, it's male and female dinosaurs breeding in the wild, and I would be really surprised if the games in the franchise don't start to follow suit there, at least a little bit, follow those tiny baby footsteps. Really, I'm just trying to open a discussion more than anything else. How do you think breeding is going to work in Jurassic World Evolution, Return to Jurassic Park? How do you think breeding countermeasures is going to function, and indeed the fluorescent breeding? It's worth pointing out as a little addition here as I think of it, it says for the fluorescent one that it's there to obviously fill in gaps in the code and also search out unwanted traits. Plural. You know, it doesn't just say it's searching out the propensity towards asexual breeding or something like that, it just says traits, it's very general. So there is the chance that there's another thing at play there, maybe the aggression of the Isla Sorna dinosaurs like the Spinosaurus, maybe this is what we're trying to avoid now, maybe it can also root out aggression, maybe that system's a little bit more advanced than it first appears, although again it's worth pointing out that fluorescent DNA thingamajiggy is also not present in sandbox mode. I just feel like the campaign is pushing the boat out a little bit more this time, so I'm really excited about that. Anyways, thanks for joining me. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. How will breeding function? How could breeding ever function? Is it something you even want in Jurassic World? And how will breeding countermeasures work? And all that kind of jazz. Finger guns. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers much of as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.